This is the structure of abstract factory pattern. We will see how this is implemented in PHP source. This is the abstract class abstract factory. It has abstract methods createProduct1 and createProduct2, so they will be implemented in its derived classes. Here is the class ConcreteFactory1 derived from class abstractFactory. Here is the implementation of method createProduct1. Inside this, it creates the object of product1_1 and returns it. Here it implements the method createProduct2. Inside this, it creates the object of product2_1 and returns it. So we can see ConcreteFactory1 is creating series 1 product, product1_1 and product2_1. Here is the class ConcreteFactory2 derived from class abstractFactory. Here it implements the method createProduct1. Inside this, it creates the object of product1_2 and returns it. Here it implements the method createProduct2. Inside this, it creates the object of product2_2 and returns it. So we can see ConcreteFactory2 is used to create series 2 product, product1_2 and product2_2. Here is the abstract class abstractProduct1. It has abstract method display, so it will be implemented in its derived classes. Here is the class product1_1 derived from class abstractProduct1. Here it implements the method display. Inside this, it just displays this statement. Here is the class product1_2 derived from class abstractProduct1. Here it implements the method display. Here is the abstract class abstractProduct2. It has abstract method display, so will be implemented in its derived classes. Here is the class product2_1 derived from class abstractProduct2. Here it implements the method display. And here is the class product2_2 derived from class abstractProduct2, and here it implements the method display. And inside this, it just displays this statement. So we'll see how all this has been used. Okay. So here we are creating the object of ConcreteFactory1 and assigning it to the variable factory1. And here we are calling the method createProduct1. So it will go to the ConcreteFactory1 createProduct1. So it will come here, it will create the object of product1_1 and will return it. So product1_1 object is assigned to the variable prod1. Now it's calling the method display. So it will go to product1_1 display. So it will come here and it will display this statement. Now it's calling createProduct2 of ConcreteFactory1. So it will come here, createProduct2 of ConcreteFactory1. So it creates the object of product2_1 and returns it. So to product2_1 object will be assigned to prod2. So when this is called, it will go to the method product2_1 display. So it will come here and it will display this. Similarly, here ConcreteFactory2 object has been created and assigns to variable factory2. So when we are calling the createProduct1, it will go to the ConcreteFactory2 createProduct1. So it will come here and it will create the object of product 1 underscore 2 and returns it. Product 1 underscore 2 object will be assigned to prod 1. So when this is called, so it will come here, product 1 underscore 2, and it will display this. Similarly, here it will call the method create product 2 of concrete factory 2. So it will come here and it will create the object of product 2 underscore 2 and returns it. So product 2 underscore 2 object will be assigned to prod 2, and when this is called, it will come here and it will display this. So we can see these set of statements are used for creating series 1 product using concrete factory 1, and these set of statements are used to create series 2 product using concrete factory 2. And after creating the products, we are using them. Okay, we'll run this program and we'll see the output. So we can see when this is called, prod 1 display, so it creates product 1 underscore 1 display statement, it will show. Because product 1 underscore 1 object has been created and assigned to prod 1 using concrete factory 1. Similarly, when this is used, it will create the product 2 underscore 1 object with previous statement, and it will go to the display method of product 2 underscore 1. See, here it has gone and display this. Similarly, when this is used, when the display method is used here, it will come here and it will display this product 1 underscore 2 display. So we can see this underscore 1, it's a series 1 product, and underscore 2 is a series 2 product. So when this is called, it comes here and it displays this statement. See this.